Greetings, this is Garthrs, the Dallas Adventure, with another episode of StarMade, and I am putting in my inventory a transporter controller, bloop, and a transporter module. Now, I'm only going to use two each of these, and I think what we're going to do is we're going to come here. This is a thing. Go to tree. Do I have any of those set? I do not. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll put a transporter right there. This is the module. And we'll put the computer right here. And then we'll select the computer and select the module. And that's how we're going to do that. That's pretty easy, huh? Now, what I'm going to do with the rest of these is, just so all you guys in StarMade know, I'm going to drop to sell. They're in the shop. So come get it. Come get it and buy them. They're up here. You don't have to make them or nothing. So let's go down here and get my thing. All right. Let's see if there's any transporter modules in the area. Okay, so we are into gravity. We stand on it like this, and we hit R. And we have planet segment, Pandora Haven, hospital, city. Look at all these cool places. This is amazing. All right, before I go anywhere, though, I want to... All right, so I want to buy one of each of these. Let's take his owner and take his owner. All right, so we're good here. Now let's go to Pandora Haven, floating dock, shipyard, city hall. Let's go to city hall and set destination. And we should be able to just go now. Oh, activate. I'm teleporting. Oh, crap. Oh, I'm good. Never mind. Oh, that was pretty cool. I like that. That was nice. Thank you very much, Gmod, for letting me land in your business. I don't know how to get out of here. How do you get out of here? Very important. Ooh, look at this. Oh, it's a door. Silly me not making it. All right, so yeah, he's done so much in here. It's ridiculous. I like this. I think Evil Giraffe did a wonderful job here. It's a wonderful job. I like how he built this up over here. Kind of like you can see it, you know? That's pretty cool. I like it. Makes me happy. Makes me very happy. Yeah, he's done some good work here. He's done some good work. You know, let's just go ahead and fly because I don't want to take forever. Alright, so now here's New Sleazeland, which hasn't seen some love in a while. And I've been hearing some good news and bad news about my fun house that someone's actually closed it off so nobody can get in. They put a rope up because people are getting lost in there. And I guess there's some bones in there, some homeless people. So I don't know necessarily that it's a bad thing. You know, everybody needs some extra bones here and there. That's not me. This is Jace. That's Jace. Yes. I'm in a hole. No, that's Sven. So I must be over this way. Or maybe I'm on the opposite. No, that's Gmodism. And I might be this way. I know I'm some way. For sure. This, I like this. This little... are you serious? What did I hit? That's some good momentum going. Up. Perfect. It's the Waffle House. It's not really a Waffle House. Come on. No, we're on Robin's drinking. Get out of here. Shh. Get out. Can I even buy a shop? There's not even a shop near me. I'm gonna have to get out and run because I don't want this guy freaking finding out I'm here because he'll charge me some kind of weird fee that I've never heard of. Let's get out of here, quick. Okay, that's nice. I like that. I guess we should probably name ours before we left. That probably would have been a good idea. I don't even know. Sleazeland hasn't really seen too much love, but it GMODEM's plate has definitely improved. It's got so much going on. It's like a little city. Well, it's not like it is, like it is a city. What is it? Who is this? Who is this? Who is it? There's no label or name or anything. What's going on here? What? There's nothing. This has been a while, because that's one of those really old docking modules. I would say really old, but it's like second gen. Not first gen. Ow. Come on. Might it be first gen? I don't know. I'm old. I'm really, really old. I don't know where anything. I'm out of memory. Okay, I like totally ran out of memory or something. I don't even know why that's an issue. I'm aligned to. And I'm not even in gravity anymore. But anyways, we're looking for my plate because I would have put these other two pieces down. You know what I'm saying? I'm flying in space where no one can hear you scream. I don't remember what I was saying anymore. Is this Jace's place? I don't think this is. This might be Jace's place. Because if this is Jace's place, I have a ship here. I'll just fly it. Because it's one of my docks that I use for my special thing. My special thing. And hopefully I don't run out of memory again. Because I have, as you can see in the bottom right-hand corner. Bottom left? Yeah, bottom left-hand corner. I have lots of memory. I don't know what the issue is. I really, really don't. I've got oodles. Oodles and oodles of memory. I paid for it. Because I like to have enough when I do my things. There it is over there. Right over there. That's mine. It's not very attractive, but it is mine. And Jace hardly ever comes over here and does any more building anymore, so what we might want to do is scavenge. Ooh, yes, scavenge. We'll have to come back later, because right now I don't have my pants with the big pockets on, so we're going to definitely have to do something about that. Get bigger pockets. Or maybe put a chest down somewhere. Or fill a chest that's in this thing. I don't know. Could be. Either way, you know what I'm saying? There's no talent. It's a thing. We could jump down the. Yeah, okay. We're in. Close that up. Let's go. Oh, wait. Hey, what's up, bro? Alright. Let's go to the fireword and come off of here. This is really difficult to fly. Whoa! What's up? Alright, there's Fuse. This is Fen. That is Lens Cap. Who's actually done a pretty good job with his plate, making it look all natural and junk. Is he even my neighbor? I love his freaking rings, though. I watched that episode and I was like, oh, that's so smart. Oh, why did I dig at that? Oh, crap. Is that me? That's me. Is that mine? I don't even know what my ships look like. I got so many freaking ships just hanging around doing nothing. It's ridiculous. Yeah, here we go. Okay. All right. So we come in here to this, right? Let's. It's really hard. They've changed some things. There we go. All right, and then we can jump out of our sheep. Come over here, right? In case you were curious of how this goes, this is how this goes. Now, Evil Giraffe was supposed to build me a nice little garden thing over here. As you can see, that never happened. Apparently, I didn't put my order in right. Let's see if I can remember how to operate this. Mm-hmm. Regardless of what one is here, I think this button does it. Did it work? Didn't work. What is this? Number three? Let's go with number three. One, two, three. Let's try this one. I don't think it's working. Let's try this. No, it didn't work either. Apparently something is broken. Something is broken. Maybe I gotta toggle them all for some reason. I don't know. Let's look. Actually, everything's still connected. This is really compact design. I was stupid happy about that. It came out so well. So let's open this up. Now, give me that. This should. This should be working. It's not working. See, what it's supposed to do is when I hit this button, it's supposed to check if there's something there. If there isn't something there, let's see, is it? It's currently knotted, so if these two knots, you should get an and, which would check for the first available slot. So it won't go to one, it won't go to two, it should go to three. So let's go through here and look and see. See, they all have knots in them. Why is that? I might have to toggle each one of these individually. That could be it. That could be it. That's gonna suck. Because as you can see, there's a thing underneath here. Oh, I see what it is. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I totally got it. I totally get it. It's got the things. We got the speed McDoohickeys. They're in here. They're all kind of. These are all on. Oh, that's what it is. Okay, so we don't have enough of these guys over here. That's probably what it is. Because it is going very slowly right now. So let's turn that back on so it knows what to do. Oh, that is not convenient at all. There's all kind of them up here. So I have these up here. I'm going to fall in the lava. I just have a feeling I'm going to re-enter gravity at the wrong gravity at the wrong time. This used to be. This is where I worked out my my logic for it. Made it nice and compact. I don't know why. I should have plenty of. Let's get in here. Basic factory. Change production. Rail. I just hit the caps lock. Rail. Nope. Is it mass? It might be mass. Nope. I'll just see if I had any. I have factory enhancers. I've got all kinds of junk in there. Look at all this crap, man.
Oh my god, I swear.
Rail mass enhancers, that's what I need. Activate production. Do we have what it takes? No. What's the active production? So we need Sintir and Crystal Composite. We don't have any Sintir. I figured that was going to be something like that. Don't have any Sintir. Look at all that. Look at all that. Oh my god, there's just so much. Oh my god. Yeah, well, we definitely got to figure that out because I know I have a few of them in here. Let's pull this out for a second. Yeah, see, I have lots in here. No, I don't. Oh, that's why. Bummer. Anyway. Yeah, well, anyway, it's going to take a week to, to get put away. But I have a ship. So let's go ahead and drop our thing down. Two. For right now, I want to put myself in the welcome center. So that's what we'll do with the teleportation thing, Meduger. Heimer. Come on down. Are you for serious? Oh my god. Everything weighs a ton, apparently. Are you? Hello? Hello? Oh my god. Are you serious? Man, you're so fat. You need to lose some weight, okay? Of course, I do only have like 8 rail enhancers. That might be somewhat the cause. It's not even moving. Oh my god, it's so slow. So we'll drop that right here in the middle. Actually, not right in the middle. Let's put this. Oh, that's exactly what I didn't want to do. I want it somewhere where it's not going to show. Yeah, no, it's going to show there. I want it somewhere where it's not going to show. Did I? Oh, perfect. So we'll put it here. Perfect. And we'll put this here. Perfect. Okay, and then we see, and then V. And then we stand on it. We get our face right in the screen. And we look at the other ones we can't reach. We didn't name it. That's what we need to do. Let's change the name on this one to Visitor Center. When it has absolutely no information. But I don't understand. Where's it gonna send me? Nowhere. Destination is out of reach. There is no destination. We got to come back to this one. Target transporter. Just, why is it not listing mine? Public access. Okay. And that's good. So this one's called Visitor Center. And we'll go change the other one. The public access and whatnot. We'll get it all worked out. See, we're learning together, you and I. Just grab this plant, make it all good. I always thought that was kind of weird. When you put this, you can see the sun through it. I thought that was kind of a weird thing. But it is what it is. Yep, it is what it is. This is one ugly ship. I go through these phases where I want to build something different, and then I finish it, and I'm never satisfied with it when it's done. Like, this is just like a little runabout. It's not even supposed to be super amazing. But, like, as soon as I got done with it, I hated it. As soon as I got done with it. So let's get off of here. I mean, it handles all right, don't get me wrong. But it's just, it's not something I really am excited about. Set our load waypoint, my garage, plot. Plot, are you plotting on me? I am plotting on you, radar jammer. So we'll go over here and we'll set up the other one, which shouldn't be too much of an issue. I mean, these teleporters are, I mean, they're kind of cool, but they're limited. I mean, like, if you teleport from one ship to another, the ship you're on and the ship you're going to will both lose their shields and have to regenerate them, which is not necessarily bad, unless you're like teleporting in the middle of combat or something. I mean, because most everybody has a fairly decent regenerate on their shield. So, I mean, it's a moderate inconvenience, but that's about what the heck is this? That's about the extent of it. What is that? Oh, that's my runabout. Oh, sweet. It's my land speed thing. I made that just to run about. And then I made that because I couldn't find my land speeder. So, as you can see, I make quality decisions all around. Just quality decisions. So let's come back over here and we'll name this one and do it right this time. Okay, also I want to show you one more thing while I'm in here. Been doing a little bit of work and I had an idea that I'm gonna have to scrap. It's a great idea and I'm probably gonna do it on Earth, like the next big station or something we build. But you have your customs, right? You come in here, there's gonna be a little customs dude, which I'm gonna get an NPC to stand in here, so it's awesome and stuff. But basically you have to be scanned for viruses. So the person hits this button and it traps you because you have to stand on that little grate thing right there and it traps you. And my plan was to open up something in the roof and jettison you into space if you were contaminated. But there's a parking platform up there, so couldn't really for really, you know what I'm saying? So let's set this one up and we're gonna change this one to Garth's Garage. Okay, we'll make it public access as well. Okay, and we'll set this one as the destination to that one. Sounds good. Set destination. Yeah, okay, so that's good. Now we just need to get in here and make the rail mass enhancer so you guys can see, because some of you may not have been with me when I made that back in the day. It's a pretty cool system. Hopefully it still works. We're looking for docking. Docking. There we go. Docking. Mass enhancers. Yep, got plenty of them. All right, let's jump out of here. We'll go get back in our massive runabout. Actually, let's just leave that one there. We'll take this little one. I don't think it's going to be... Actually, we don't need to do that. We can just go down... We can do the thing. We'll just leave them both up here. Come on. Close the door on myself. Don't do it, Garth. Don't do it, Garth. Actually, let's enter gravity and see what happens. We're in gravity, and then we activate this puppy. Boom. It should take me downstairs to the thing. Will I still be in gravity? No, I am not in gravity. All right, that makes a difference. So we'll go to this one, and we'll go Garth's Garage, set destination. So now we can go back and forth freely. It's public access. It is what it is. I would really wish I could go back and forth freely. Come on, jump up and down on it. It's not working. Crap. Let's go over here and get in this. You're gonna have all kinds of video footage on this one because my freaking recording software stopped twice on me. Big jerk. Alright, so we have this stuff. Let's come back here and we'll just fill up some of these cubby holes. Yeah, we'll just put them right here. Just like that. I don't know how many you need. I think you're supposed to like have one of these for every like 1,000 mass, I believe, but I could be wrong. It's probably a lot less. Sven probably knows that number. He's really good with numbers and junk. All right, so as you can see, it's now put away. So let's come over here and hit the 3 button because that's the one we want. Oh yeah, that's much more better. When it comes out, it'll swing it rear end away here in a second. There you go, and it'll come out this way. Instead of putting this in the middle, I put it in the front because I wanted it to swing out big this way. I like the bigger movement. I think the obvious movement is better in my opinion. Some people like a more smooth transition, I should say, but I personally think it's just fine the other way. So let's go ahead and hit this button to park it. It should put me back in 3 because 3 is the open spot. And if you look over here, you can see that 3 is opened, as you can see right there. It tells me 3 is open. So when it goes looking for the circuit, it knows to run the segment to park in 3 because 3 is open. There you go. So that's it. That's the parking thing. Now, if I wanted to say take spot 2 out when I go, then I would come over here and hit the 2. Like that. And 2 comes out. And then I could take 2 wherever I wanted to take 2. And these fit. I mean, I got a little bit of room on either side, but I didn't want to squeeze it in there like perfectly. But it's pretty sweet. I like it. It works out pretty well. The thing I'm most impressed with is the way I was able to work out the logic. The logic itself is like stinking simple. I was so surprised when it came out. I mean, it looks like a freaking nightmare back there, but it's all basically the same module in several different setups, and each one of these little setups controls the sequence at which the rails turn and what rotates what direction and all this. There's an in channel and an out channel, so if I need to call it from parking to departures, it'll run this channel. And if I need to park it from, you know, arrivals to parking, then it'll run this channel. And this basically just runs through here. Like, as you can see now, there's a knot here. So when it runs down when I hit this button, it'll go down these and say, is one parked? Yes. Let's go to 2. Is one parked? No. Let's run 2 then. So that's how it figures it out. So when I hit this button, you'll see it'll run the, this will be the second command right here. Watch this. See, it gave me a not here, or an and here, because it checks for this and this. So if it gets both of them, it's basically don't park here because there's something here, and then it'll go where it needs to go. It's pretty smart, and I ran the piping down underneath the floor so that you can't see it until it comes over here. All of them come through the floor over here, so you can't really see it right now, but there's a module underneath here, right there. So it's I thought it was a pretty good idea. It worked out well for me, and definitely works out. I like it, and it's all set up. I mean, it's got buttons in the back because I want this to stay illuminated until it parks. So when I call spot three, boom, spot three stays illuminated until it pulls up here to the front, and then this button will go out because I have a little reset circuit in the back here, which turns everything back the way it's supposed to be. Pretty sweet, right? I know. It's pretty awesome. So watch when it pulls in here. Let's go over here real fast so you can see both the light and the parking. But you'll see the light go out, this light right here, go out when it finishes moving. That's how I know that the system is done. And that's how I know that I can do anything. And as long as one of these lights are lit, like I can come over here and hit this one to park it, and then I have to immediately hit one, nothing is happening. Because it knows that the system is currently busy, so it immediately turns that circuit back off so that nothing happens. I think it's pretty smart. I mean, I enjoy how it turned out. I was pretty impressed with it. Like, I can't even call three right now because it'll immediately turn it off, even though three is the one that's getting parked. So, I mean, it won't take any inputs if it has inputs already. Oh, crap. I hit the wrong one. Took me about 2 weeks to work out the logic because I was trying to go big so I could look at it and see what was happening. And all day was confused the crap out of myself because I had this freaking humongous amount of logic over here, and then I had a bunch of logic over here, and then I had rails coming down and over and around, and I had it so complicated because I was spreading it out so I could see what I was doing. But when it came right down to it, I didn't need to. I just needed to build one module and then work out my sequencing logic, and it basically just came together like you wouldn't believe. So let's call our parking spot. I need to go down. Where am I supposed to be? There I am. I need to go down. Let's see if my elevator works now. Elevator takes me down pretty far, so that's good. There's two elevators. There's one over here, I believe, and one over here. Yeah, here's the other one. I just don't know exactly where it's at right now. There we go. And I'm currently, are you gonna do anything? I don't know why the logic is broke on this, because this worked not too long ago. This is a simple little switch. If it's down, send it up. If it's up, send it down. See, nothing is working right now. I can't figure that out at all. The logic's back here. I'll work that out later, but I just want to get out of here. I want to go back up to my station because there's something I want to show you guys, and then I'm going to get out of here because, well, psh, whatever. So three, that's what I want. Give me three. And then we'll come over here and just wait for it. And if I don't like how fast it's going, I can turn it down with a speed controller over there. It's connected to all of these, the rails. I was actually thinking about bringing everything down so you couldn't see the rails. But I like the rails. I think the rails add something to it. I'm not extremely picky when it comes to aesthetics, but I do believe that the rails should be seen. Because once I thought about taking them away, I actually got sad. I was like, oh man, I'm so sad. And I stopped being sad. Flying into space is like my favorite thing on this planet because the sky is so stinking blue. And my ship is apparently too heavy to leave atmosphere. Nailed it. I was hitting E and W, so I was flying up and over. I basically just did a big loop. Yeah, I nailed it. I nailed it. I sorted that. You don't even know. I wish I was just half as impressive as I thought I was just now. That sucks. Alcoholic beverage. That's what happened. I'm going to blame it on the beer. I'm looking at probably a 30-minute episode, and there's not really much going on right now, but I'm going to do a little show and tell, and then we'll get out of here. You guys can go do your thing, because I'm sure you got things to do. Everybody's got things to do. I got things to do. That's why I'm getting out of here. You guys can't count them with me, because one of the things I'm going to do is get ready for bed, and it's just awkward with 3,626 subscribers trying to get underneath the same comforter. It's not something you can do easily. I'm not saying it's not something I don't want to do. I don't want you guys to walk away from this feeling like I don't love you. I mean, the attraction I have for you is there. I wouldn't say, you know, it's strong, but it's definitely there. I mean, there's some of you more than others, you know. But, you know, not everybody. So don't feel bad, because I know some of you, I'm obfuscated, whatever that means. Press up. Right, let's just get in here. Okay. Now I'm out. That was much more better. I don't know what the heck just happened with obfuscation. I'm still moving. Okay, I'm just going to leave you there. That's fine. Totally fine. Obfuscated. I don't know what that means. Is that bad? Do I need to go see a doctor? Obfuscated. It's probably had something to do with that attraction comment I made. Everybody was like, oh my god, that's weird. And that's what obfuscated means. To be weird. This is the heavy hand. It is something that I'm currently working on. It's not amazing. It's not anything by any stretch of the imagination amazing. It's only in first phase right now. What I'm doing, I'm designing it in several phases. There's going to be the initial phase, which is general rough design. And then we have the secondary phase where I'm going to go with the fleshing out of the different bits and pieces of it. And then there's going to be the final phase, which is going to be like incredible detailing. I'm going to go in there and where you've got huge tracks of just flat fuselage. For those of you who don't know what that means, that's the body of the aircraft or the vessel, fuselage. I'm obfuscated again. But that's effectively what I'm going for here. Just working on minor details, because I tend to make things that are very, very flat. This is my first real experiment in dimensions, and I don't think it really experiments with dimensions other than taking a flat thing that I made and putting ridges on it. That's not exercise. You know, that's not exercise in being more better. So what I'm trying to do is go through here and make things that are not just so flat and two-dimensional that they look like 90-degree angles or 45-degree angles that somebody decided to throw some equipment on. This needs to get fixed. But effectively, what this is going to be is kind of a smuggling ship. I mean, listening post for eavesdropping on my... galactic radio wave interpretation. There we go. And it's going to have a couple of compartments in it for, you know, cargo that needs to be protected from people looking at it, because you don't want them to do that. Effectively, it's going to have two humongous, like, weapon arrays in the front. It's going to have a weapon array in the middle there. It's going to have probably about six turrets. I'm looking at having one here and one here on either side. Or possibly two on the dorsal and four on the bottom. These are kind of be like smaller turrets, except for one of them, which is going to be pretty big. That's what I'm kind of shooting for. The heavy hand, in my opinion, is a little more firepower than is needed and a lot more thrust than you could ever really possibly want, but you will need it because we'll be running operations where we're going to have to get away from things. Some of those things are going to be on our team. Some of those things are not. I'm not going to say any more than that because I don't want to, what's the word I'm looking for here? It's a pleading the fifth, basically, incriminate myself any further than I already have. But it's just a frame right now, and I'm just working on it kind of like here and there, pieces and bits. So I'm working with some minor detailing, some angles. So I'm not really entirely happy with all of them. There's some of them that are pretty cool, I think, in my opinion, and others that I'm not really behind yet. Right now, it's it's planed in the middle, so it's kind of, it's somewhat like this up here, but there's some differences, minor differences that I just got to clean up around. But effectively, that's what I'm looking at here. Just, this is like an exercise in me being not so very, very flat. It looks very flat now, but it's not done. This is the main core of the body, and a majority of this chunk right here, in the top, is going to get moved around, and there's going to be some more flares, something akin to this, but further back here, which is going to kind of cover up some of this detailing, but it should have abundant room where you can still see it, and I think that'll look nice. But for the most part, this is going to be my most non-standard ship ever, because you can see a lot of my ships have just huge planes of just flat, like even these walkways right here. Look how long these walkways are. I even put this here just so I didn't have this huge plane. That was my idea, breaking up the monotony. Take it up four steps and it carry on with some more monotony. I'm telling you, my brain, while you guys may think it's creative, it tends to be very repetitive. When I get a thing that works for me, I tend to kind of work on it. And in space, we don't have to build along this plane, the horizontal plane. We could build on the vertical plane, and we could build on the diagonal plane, and we could build whatever plane we want to build on. But I tend to stick to those safety planes. You know, this is like left to right, straight, flat, let's do it. And I'm trying to break away from that. And this is one of those exercises in that. The heavy hand, when done, should be my most detailed ship to date. It's not going to have an amazing interior. We're not like, I don't mean amazing, but like huge interior. It's going to be a fairly small interior. There's going to be a small cargo here. There's going to be a bridge up here. There's going to be probably some quarters over here, and I think and like engine room and damage control over here or something like that. That's kind of what I'm shooting for right now. It's just very minimal because it's designed for a small crew to run long, run fast, run hard. That's what it's designed to do. And hopefully it's fun. We don't know. I'll be working on off and on. I'll be giving you updates. Probably won't do too much on camera building, because a majority of what I do is tear down what I just did and do something else. So we'll probably focus some more on the Panther / Warthog, which is close to completion. I've got both of those wired up. I just gotta get some of those inner wire remotes hooked up. I have basically one over here, and then one in the middle that controls both of them. And that'll be it. Or two wireless and then one inner ship remote, which will fire both missiles at the same time. That's the plan. And I believe that she is just about done. I've got a majority of my, this is like a freaking vomit of color, but I like it, so it is what it is. Got my server bays back here. It's pretty nice, I like it. Okay, get out of here, I got things to do. I'm serious. Okay, for those of you who's still in the video, it was a test. I'm actually out. There's another 45 minutes of footage. I'm just kidding. I'm out of here. Talk to you guys later.
See ya.